we'll talk about the Fourier series expansion for periodic waveforms. I've shown one example here, a square wave, which is repeating over period T, as shown here. Another example could be a sawtooth waveform, also repeating over T here. Any waveform that's repeating can be written out as a Fourier series expansion, which just means we take that waveform and we divide it up into various coefficients multiplied by sines and cosines. The frequency that we operate, there's a fundamental frequency, omega, and that's defined as 2 pi f, where f can also be written as 1 over t. Here is the definition of the Fourier series expansion, and let's go through each part. A0 is a coefficient, it's called the DC coefficient, and it's defined here. You'll notice we're taking the function f of t, we're integrating it over the period, and then we're dividing by t. This is the same as the average. So this term is simply the average of the waveform. Then we have many terms here. We have the series from n equals 1 to infinity, and we have a cosine term that's multiplied by a of n. So this is the coefficient for the cosine term, and it's defined here. So a of n, you would multiply 2 divided by t times the integral from 0 to t of the function, your periodic function here, multiplied by the cosine of whichever n you're looking at, omega t. So you can do mathematical analysis, solve for that term, a of n, you put it into here. And again, this n is going to be whichever multiple of the fundamental frequency that you're looking at. B of n is the same exact thing as defined here. The only difference between these two formulas is cosine and sine. So you do the exact same multiplication equation, and you use sine instead of cosine. So you can solve for that, put that into here for whichever multiple of the fundamental frequency you're looking at. So here to here is the full definition of the Fourier series expansion. You can go through and solve for each of these values based on your function and get the full expansion. An alternate form of the Fourier series expansion is shown here, and this is the one that we will be using for harmonic analysis of periodic waveforms. The same function, our periodic function, and we start with the same DC term, so A of 0 shown here. And we combine the cosine and the sine terms together into one term, which means that our coefficient value will change. So C of n now becomes this value. So C of n is defined as a square root of an squared plus bn squared. And because we're combining the two together, we actually end up with a phase shift. So phi of n here can be defined as the inverse tangent of an divided by bn. We'll be using this form of the Fourier series expansion. So let's actually write out the first couple terms and talk about what they mean. So we can rewrite our periodic waveform as A0 plus, let's evaluate at n equals 1. So C1 equals sine of n is equal to 1, so that can just not be written, omega t plus phi of n, oops, phi of 1. Okay, that's one term. Now let's write out the second one. We would evaluate at n equals 2, so C2 sine of 2 omega t plus phi 2 plus the rest of the coefficients. This first term is called the DC component, and it is the same as the average of the periodic waveform. In these cases, it would actually be 0 because there's no DC offset, but if you have some offset, then you can have a non-zero value for A0. This term is called our fundamental, where n equals 1. So we're looking at the fundamental frequency of our periodic waveform, and so that's for only when n equals 1. All of the higher ones are what we call the harmonics. So anyone from n equals 2 to infinity, those are the harmonics of our periodic waveform. We've defined the full Fourier series expansion, which is given here in this definition. However, we tend to use this form of the Fourier series expansion, where we combine the an and bn terms into one new coefficient, c of n, defined here, and we use just one term. When we break our signal down, we have the first component is the DC component, n equals 1 is the fundamental, and anything higher than that is considered harmonics.